Bioethics.
Law. Euthanasia.
Consumerism.
Politics.
Terrorism.
Globalization.
Religion.
Migrant population.
Interfaith. Drug addiction.
Okay, so what is social media? Okay, so these are some social media that are commonly, some services are commonly said to be social media, okay? Facebook is a common one, that's the number one. LinkedIn is the professional sort of group for Facebook. And those of you who are below collection of CPF, okay? You should be on LinkedIn because people have gotten jobs from LinkedIn. I had a student who got a double promotion. Okay, she got promoted through LinkedIn. On the day she turned up in the office, she was the most junior vice president and everybody else was senior vice president. So the boss promoted her on the spot. LinkedIn, okay, you were told. Google Plus, another social media site, similar to Facebook. Twitter, not so popular here in Singapore generally, Twitter, but there. Instagram, okay, I just got an Instagram account, like, alamak, so many things already got Instagram. Okay? No, the reason is that I have so many things to work with, and my students sometimes force me to use that. Okay, you know, should we connect on this, Facebook, you know, so forth. Okay. Okay, so these are photos, right? Uploading photos. Video, of course, you know, YouTube. Vimeo is another one, I'm coming. Reviews, I use TripAdvisor a lot in travel. I give my comments, the site. Opinions was it's a review site of products and services, and actually I was with this guy at Stanford when he was talking about starting it. This guy can talk non-stop. So I was in a car from like 11 p.m. to like 1 a.m. and he was like talking, and I got to go and sleep, you know. Okay. And his opinion, I said, it cannot work in Singapore because there's defamation law in Singapore. What if you write a bad review, then, you know, it's not true. Okay, didn't start it. So, but he started it, and then I guess it's gone on to fame and riches. Amazon, okay, even Amazon has got a social media part because of the reviews. Reviews about books, about the videos and so forth. So Amazon has got some reviews there. Curating, what it means is that it tells you where to go. So there are some sites that tell you, like, okay, these are good things to read. We got a lot of material out there, right? Good things to read, good things to view. Okay, so these are some of these. And then one that you don't normally think of as a social media group, but it is social media in the sense that it's a closed group, but it's kind of like a Facebook Messenger, right? It's kind of closed, and you do trade information, you do send up links and so forth. And depending on how you do it, okay, some of these groups are sort of open to other people to join, okay, but often by invitation. This will typically still be seen as a form of social media, okay. All right. So some of these, a common factor in all of these is this, okay. User-generated content, okay. So that is the key part of user-generated content. And you may not think about this, but when you click on a news item, a news article, you are affecting the content. Because the more you click, the higher it ranks, it goes up in popularity. And then people say, oh, other people click on this, must be good, right? So you click on it. So that is why, okay, if you see stuff that you don't like, okay, like, typically about naked women, I'm not a naked man, but naked man people don't see, but naked woman, okay, people see. So, naked woman something, then, oh, okay, normally you click and then that rises, right? So if you don't want to, so one of the things I tell my students that if you don't want to see some things on a news site, don't click on it. Because when you click on it, it affects the ranking and that makes it more popular. That makes it go viral. Okay? This is an algorithm, a mathematical formula that is used in a lot of sites. There's in fact one website called Upworthy, with the right as many as 25 headlines for one article. And the headline that has the most clicks, they use that. Okay, so it tells you how important all these kind of click-throughs are. The key is user-generated content, okay, in this social media site. And user-generated content, what it means is that you all do the work, you see. You do the work, they sell the advertising. So actually, you created the work, okay. You're working for a company. Are you being paid? No. In a former life, These are called slaves, you know. Yeah, but let's not go there. Okay? Okay, social media, now how big is it? So among Christian groups, I don't know whether you're some among you, but maybe not like this group, because you all take a bus, park and all that, and walk down or come here, okay? There's some groups that I find that where they think that old is good, like hymns, spiritual, choruses, okay, right? Anything before 1800, after that, then recently, because so they want everything like old. So I've met people who like no Facebook account, you know, young people, you know, Christian, nice Christian people, you know, you don't mind getting a son or daughter married to them, but no Facebook account, you know, no Facebook account, you know, so strange. But it's important, to use social media because of the scale of it, you know, okay. So this data is a bit old, okay. It's a bit old, but the whole point is still valid, okay. Research says that in order to have TV that's interesting to watch, you need 120 channels. On, I don't mean like StarHub, I have 120 channels, but must subscribe for each one, you know. Most people like 50 at most, right? 120 means that anything, you sit down, you turn on TV, something interesting to watch. Okay, cable TV, you know, when you watch, means that you don't like, this is a time you sit down and watch, no. You sit down, then the TV comes on and it's interesting to watch. That's how cable TV is supposed to work. Okay, I know it doesn't work in Singapore that way, but it's how it's supposed to work. Okay, that's why people are using Netflix and all these, you know, streaming media. You sit down, you control the TV. So 120 channels, and then the cable system could, in fact, this is my studying, okay, late 80s, early 90s, I'm not dating myself, late 80s, early 90s, you could, cable TV systems can have 500 channels already, you know. 500 channels, okay. And more like, hey, how do you feel 500 channels of TV? How do you fill up? It cannot fill up. We have all the space, it cannot fill up. You see, look, YouTube, 100 hours every minute. Every minute. You have to be like time machine, you know, go back in time and then watch, you know. Go back in time, you all go and kill baby Hitler. Go back in time, kill baby Hitler. Go back in time, watch TV for what? I mean, go back in time, watch TV, right? Go back in time, kill baby Hitler, do the world a good. But 100 hours of video every minute, imagine that. So we now have a lot of videos that you can, I know a lot of them are junk, but you can have a lot anyway, right? Facebook posts, when I did this one, this was data 2013, you say that Facebook will be bigger than China and India. Facebook is now bigger than China, 1.6 billion users. Okay, China 1 point something. So if Mark Zuckerberg were a leader of a country, ruler of the world, master of the universe, you know. Okay, that's how big it is, the scale. Okay, now why is this? So look at this photo, right? Same location, same kind of event, ordination of the Pope. Okay, some people call it enemy, but the Pope. Okay, Catholic, you know. Don't know that, I'll come to that, the Catholic Protestant issue, right? It's a, any Catholic place is a joke, y'all know. like a stone, like a scratch or whatever, you know. Okay, so 2005, you see, okay, everybody like, you know, like, what you doing, quite quiet, like, hey, here. 2013, look, everyone has got a phone device, right? And this is it, it's a smartphone that's creating this possibility. Right, the connection that's always on, you know, and so forth. So, this is quite a famous photo showing sort of the prevalence of the smartphone, okay? And in fact, there was a prize-winning photo, a news photo, I don't know whether you saw this one, migrants in, I think, Somalia or something, where it's across the sea and they were holding up the phone to try and get a signal, something like that, yeah? And they won a prize for that. Okay. So the technology makes it possible. Okay, so why not before? So basically, the answer is the technology. Okay. So I put this up here also to make this point that I know it's hard to believe, but the pieces are social media, and we thought we were modern people, you know. Okay, if it's not. And my wife and I have been to Turkey, we walked through, you know, some the chapels and all that. By the way, Turkey, if you go to Turkey, they have a tour called the Seven Churches Tour, you know. Seven churches are there. Except that you only see four churches. I told my friend, what is Turks? Really a chow quad, you know. Really, you know. Cheat you, you know. You pay to see seven churches, you only see four. Because the other three are demolished already. Nothing to see. What happened? This is cheating me. Okay. But when you go there, you realize that, okay, the only way that you must spread the message is through this social media, because, you know, the way it's, they're persecuted, you know, right? The catacombs, underground cities and all that. So how to spread, like, hey, quietly, hey, spread the word, okay? Right. So social media, and you can see there are some instances of what Paul said, what Paul said that, after you read, please post this on our equivalent of Facebook. That's what he's saying. Okay? Not in so many words, but roughly what he's saying, right? Modern translation. I charge you before the Lord, okay? I you know, formal language, I charge you before the Lord. Have this letter read to all brothers and sisters. Okay? So, it's a form of social media. Okay? And in fact, one author makes the case that if you say that, you know, as Christians, we are people of the book, he says, no, actually, we are people of the letters. Okay. Again, I put this up to show, make the point that this issue of social media is not just something burst onto the scene by Mark Zuckerberg. It's been there in different forms, but it's been there before. Okay. Any questions about social media? You understand, right? Key is user-generated. You influence the media, believe it or not. You influence what content that comes up. Okay. All right. Now, some research about social media. Okay, so I put this up here, the six types. Okay, wait, let me tell you, I have 40 slides. We have 40 minutes. Some slides are like one line, so it's okay, quite fast. But it means that I have to go quite fast in any case. So please, your questions, please note, and then we'll answer them. This one, I put it up here because it describe kind of the use of social media in a way that I think most of us don't often think about. Okay, so we often think of social media for obviously communication. So the circle kind of shows how big the impact is. Social communication, okay, coordination, meaning that hey, let's meet at Orchard Cinema at this time, right? The connection there, okay, or let's do it, and meet could be like, hey, let's all people of, you know, Jurong, meet at this place, to protest, whatever. So that's about coordination. I'm not saying to, okay. This in the term is called micro coordination. After the second, micro coordination. Let's meet this minute, okay? And it's why government stopped the internet from connecting, because you want to stop the micro coordination, to break the micro coordination, okay? A connection, of course, like, hey, hi, you know, how are you, right? Okay, see that in photos. This one is contemplation, and the idea is that you guys would have received this. Somebody sends you something, you don't expect a response, just expect to think about it. A nice quote, inspirational quote, you know, right? Something to think about, the mull over, contemplation. I'll come to this at the end. Creativity, of course, you can see how people, you know, the what they call the mashups, right, of funny photos, you know, funny quotes. Curation, again, is the point about how people send you interesting links, okay? It's just interesting, like classic cat videos. You don't contemplate cat videos, you just watch it and have fun, and just move on, okay? Alright, so six types of social media. Just sort of talk very briefly about how to use them in the religious life. Okay, so now the research on the not so that first types, right? Now the not so positive part of social, and I begin here the not so positive parts first. Okay, all right. So I don't know if you heard this thing called FOMO, fear of missing out. Okay, some of you have heard FOMO. Okay, so this is the first thing, right? So if you're too much on social media, you need to start feeling, hey, did I miss something or not? Am I being left out or not? So that's why people go use social media. Okay, it's actually a fear that to be left out, not connected, right? Second one, known phenomenon, Facebook envy. It's a phrase, Facebook envy, because you see a lot, use a lot of Facebook. People put only happy photos on Facebook most of the time. Okay? So then you see, like, wow, this person, look at the food eating, so good. Look at the holiday, he's gone. Wow, look at the sunset he's seeing. Wow. Then, like, I'm working, you know, I'm taking MRT. It's sweaty, you know, smelly, you know. So this is a known phenomenon. In fact, they find that people use a lot, and by a lot means like hours, hours. They have some depression. So of course then sort of treat them. No, yeah, it's true, because you see everybody having a good life, and then you're not. And of course it's not true. Right? You just capture the highlights of people's days, you know. Right? And people put happy moments on, just like have, you know, a holiday and so forth. So, yeah. So this is known, okay? And then this one is selectivism. Okay. Okay. Clicking is doing. Selectivism. Okay. This is selectivism. Okay. Clicking is doing. Clicking is doing. Okay. So my friend in Chula Chulalongkorn in Thailand, they have this, you know, the flood some a few years back, a massive flood, right? So they have a Facebook page. Okay, those who want to help, you know, please sign up on Facebook and tell them who needs help where and so forth, right? She found that only 13% of people who had signed up on Facebook page actually did something. 13%. Okay? So it tells you actually, you know, people, this phenomenon, you know, the feeling that by clicking, I'm doing something really. So in fact, one famous guy wrote, you know, click to save the world, you know? So you just click and you know, this is enough really. Okay, so this is a downside in the sense that, you know, instead of going out to do something, they feel that if they're using the mouse, they are doing something. And of course, that's not the case. Right? So not so positive thing. This one is the issue of the selfies. And it's sort of inappropriate behavior. Okay, but I feel this is one of those cases where it just takes time to work out the etiquette. So this will eventually work out. But you can see that selfies are so big and, you know, people have been killed with selfies, right? Taking selfies in dangerous locations. Okay. Okay. This one is always on. Issue of being always connected and issues always connected. Is it always addicted or not? So in fact, I'm doing some research in this area in the city of Ahmedabad in Gujarat in India. We had to cut the mobile internet to prevent micro coordination for riots. We find of course that people are anxious when they don't have mobile phones. You all should know that. No? Without a mobile phone, you feel anxious. It's a known phenomenon, okay? It's not, don't take it personally, it's everywhere around the world. Okay? In fact, they're discussing whether we should call this, give it a name or not. The name is nomophobia. No mobile phobia. Like, oh no, no mobile. No. Okay? Discussing this. You can also see, you can ask that, what's wrong with being always on, isn't it like a watch, right? Okay, but I know nowadays young people know watch, right? That's different, right? Right, so what's wrong with it, right? The idea is that you should be able to live without it, right? And so if you require, it's like some kind of syndrome, yeah? Okay. So this is an issue that, you know, like I said, we're discussing, talking, answers not worked out yet. Okay, this one is, a term that was defined by a lady who observed what they call the problem of continuous partial attention. Okay, the older folks are close to withdrawing CPF. Okay, CPF is like a benchmark here, CPF and not CPF. Okay, we didn't have the smartphone all the time, right? So we kind of live in a period where there's no smartphone. And people talk to you, you must pay attention. But today, right, they have smartphone, right? So you talk to them, they're still using a smartphone, no? Right? In the lecture, they are listening and using a smartphone. Okay? So it's partial attention, right? Partial to you and partial to the phone. And it's continuous, on all the time. Right? So it's continuous partial attention. Okay? All the research says, 100%, not 90%, 100% of the research says that you can't do that. My daughter says, you believe me or you believe research, my daughter. Tough call, very tough call. Okay, I'm academic. Okay. So, although many young people feel that they can do both, the research shows that you actually cannot. Okay, and there are consequences. I mean, one, of course, being that you actually don't do things very well, or you overlook things, or you do both badly, things like that, okay? Here, and the idea is that, you know, 1 minute, don't read, don't talk, no photo, just don't see. Sort of just pay attention to one thing and forget everything else, okay? So in our family, we have this notion that you must, at dinner time, put a phone aside. The term that, like, of course, is I'm being academic here, and you're free to use this term, social presence. social plan. You're present, but you, your soul here or not? Is the soul here or not? Or your soul is like there, you know? Social presence. You can't say soul, but it's social presence. Okay? This one, okay, so you all can read because scribble too small. Kids cannot get participation credit unless the phone is turned into the spot, to their spot where class starts. So there's like a bag, like those, you know, slippers kind of thing, and then the phone must be put there before they get points. Okay, cool. So you can see it's an issue in education. For a while, some schools in the US, Ivy League, Berkeley, and so places like that, they were turning off the Wi-Fi at lecture theaters because Facebook was very popular and students were actually doing Facebook and not listening to lectures, so they turned off the Wi-Fi. Okay. At NTU, I think NUS as well, we now allow this. We allow this, but I think partly because the face of Facebook, popularity of Facebook, has sort of declined a little bit. Okay, so the problem kind of goes away. Okay, now the more positive parts. Okay, I don't know. How many have heard of this notion, the strength of weak ties? Okay, so not many of you have. Okay, this is the word itself. You can Google it, and it's on Wikipedia, which means it's real and major, okay. This is a phenomenon observed by a sociologist at Stanford. It's one of those weird things in social science where it's not really proven, but it is sort of, yeah, it's real, you know, okay. And the idea here is that we get our resources from weak ties, okay. A weak tie is this. The very clear case of weak tie is you know a friend of a friend. The second friend is a weak tie because you know him or her through your friend. If you have a close friend, it's a strong tie. Okay? So you have a weak tie and a strong tie. The weak tie is where you get the resources. Like tip off about jobs, news about things, you know. The weak tie. It's not a strong tie. I think older folks would understand it better that like your jobs and all that, you typically don't get it from a close circle of friends because the circle is kind of small, almost by definition. It is a larger circle where you're more likely to get this kind of, you know, tips about your jobs and so forth. So it is the weak ties that actually give you resources, resources in the broad sense. So what happened in social media is that it helps you develop weak ties. Okay, yeah, of course, it strengthens your strong ties, right, your bonding, but also allows you to have weak ties. So the social media network that you have, and so your friend of a friend, allows you to build that weak tie. I mean, you observe, you see this, like I said, it's one of those weird things where it's not really proven, okay, but it's sort of been accepted and people see, yeah, weak ties are where it's at. So which is why, you know, the networks are very important here, and useful. Some of my friends have done research showing that your social media can build social capital. Social capital means good stuff like cooperativeness, you know, a group social, cooperativeness, kindness, helpfulness, okay. So social media has been shown to be able to do some of that. Social media, there are many times where it is bad, it's nasty, you see the comments and so forth, it can be nasty, but the point is that it's not entirely nasty, so that's important to keep in mind. Not entirely nasty, you can do some good things out of that, social capital. So example I gave is this Haze. Okay, I actually run a Facebook page to fight the haze in Singapore. Okay, I know, it's like, wow, but it's nothing. My daughter's Pokemon trading card group. Okay. Okay, even bigger. Pokemon Go comes even bigger, right? Pokemon trading card group. 12,000 members. My Haze group, 3,000 members. 4 times more people interested in trading Pokemon card and fighting the Haze, okay? Okay. But I can do some things. So you think of the boycotts, that's partly, okay, not, I won't claim the credit, please, but some good will come out of this kind of groups. Okay, then create transparency. Through social media, because you know, like the vigilantism, right? Okay, Jovo Chu case. Okay, the guy was forced this Vietnamese guy to basically to kneel down and back in front of him. Then he went viral. Then, you know, everything came out on him, a roof and all that came on him, on Jovo Chu, right?